Imagine having the time and money to follow your passions and live life on your own terms. Welcome to Podcasting Mastery, where you'll learn the secrets of podcasting your way to a stress-free lifestyle. Let's grab a cool tropical drink and then join James, Kimberly, and the Turtle in the Secret Beach Hut Studio.
Yes, this is James Martel along with Kimberly Chuknowski.
Hello, everyone.
And we are again tucked into the Secret Beach Hut Studio, and we are very glad you've decided to join us. In the last episode, we talked about how to set up a recording studio so that you can sound like a pro and do it all for less than $100. This week, though, we're going to continue our conversation about developing a lifestyle business so we can all spend less time doing business and more time enjoying our families, more time traveling, and more time doing all of the things that matter to us most. It's for these reasons we focus on strategies for both developing a passive monthly income stream and passive ways of developing new clients and customers for your business. Today we are going to talk about how to make money podcasting even if you don't have a product of your own. Kimberly, how are you doing today?
I am doing very well, thanks, James. How about yourself?
Doing well, doing well. This is a great topic, one that I always look forward to talking about, something I've had a great deal of experience with, and I'm looking forward to digging in.
Yeah, it should be good. So to set up the tone of the show, let's play a little bit of Hawaiian music today to help get us in the mindset of working less, earning more, and swimming with the turtles.
Hawaii. You have to love Hawaii. Those listeners that have been there, you know exactly what I'm talking about, I do believe. And for those of you who haven't managed to check that off your bucket list yet, Hawaii is a magical place. My favorite island of them all is Maui, and it's actually inspired the turtle. And, of course, who's with us today. I always enjoy watching the little bugger scurry around. He's pretty funny.
And nameless. He's a no-name. There's no shame in no-name, though.
That's so true, and we haven't talked about that for a bit. We are not naming him until we hit 1,000 subscribers on the show. So we need you to help us help him. And he is a he. At least we think he's a he.
He's going through an identity crisis.
But that's the goal we set once we hit 1,000 subscribers to the Podcasting Mastery podcast, which you can subscribe to over at podcastingmastery.com. And we'd encourage you to do that right now, if you would. And then as soon as we do that, we're going to put a contest together. We're going to all decide on what his name should be. Now, let's talk about, Kimberly, let's kind of tee up this this session today, the How to Make Money Podcasting, even if you don't have a product of your own. Of course, I would think many listeners are looking at podcasting or maybe engaged in podcasting to develop more clients and customers for your existing business, whether you're a chiropractor or a mortgage broker, real estate agent, could be a naturopath. We've even seen funeral home kick off a beautiful podcast that we talked about in an earlier episode. So there's no shortage of small businesses and business professionals that can take advantage of a podcast to drive more business through the door. But today, what I think we should focus on, and although there'll be some advantages and benefits to those type of business owners as well, but what I'd like to talk about today is the lifestyle entrepreneurial type person who's looking to create a podcast to generate revenue and earn a passive monthly income. Maybe they want to work for themselves. Maybe they don't have their own business and they're looking to break away from an existing employee-boss relationship that they're not getting along with too well. What do you think?
Yeah, definitely. There's a lot of people who also feel like they have no time when they're going to a 9-to-5 every day or whichever time they are. But when you're tied to going into an office or working somewhere else, you might not have the time that you want to be spending on things that you really enjoy doing. You might not like answering to somebody, which I think is the case for quite a few people out there. You might want a different type of lifestyle where you can go on the road and you know, you don't have to wait for your 2 weeks off a year. So I think those are the type of people who will be talking about.
I was listening to the radio this morning, and the SkyTrain, which is our major commuting artery that funnels people into the city to go to work, had a fire on one of the tracks. I guess they were grinding the tracks last night, and there was a bird's nest in there somewhere which caught fire and burnt a major telecommunications cable up there and shut the whole system down.
That's crazy.
And I'm thinking, these poor buggers, they're commuting downtown. First of all, I can't even relate to that. But here they are, they've been stuck on the train and in transit for over 3.5 hours.
Oh,
on a Friday
like you might
morning.
As well just turn around and go back home.
Oh, shoot me, please. Absolutely shoot me. And then there was a, I guess a couple of days ago, I was downtown Vancouver just for something fun, and I realized I wasn't watching the time, and the next thing you know, I got to get home, which is now officially a commute, and it's 4:45, and it took me 1.5 hours to drive home. And I'm thinking, people do this every day. How do they do it? And now I've done it in the past, long, long time ago. I've had the good fortune of working from home for over 20 years, so it's not something that's on the top of my mind. But I do remember it, and once in a while I get that reminder when I do get stuck in a commute. And no thank you.
Yeah, I'm with you there.
So
my commute's about 10 feet, and I want to keep it that way. One thing I wanted to mention, actually, before you get into it, a group of people that, when you were listing all the different types of people who could benefit from podcasting, mm-hmm. I think there's also a large group of people out there who already are podcasting and love podcasting and have an audience and just enjoy talking about a subject they love, but they don't have a business built around it and they're not monetizing it. So I think we can actually speak to them as well. They might not have a product. It might be a conversation type episode or show, you know, based on opinions and things like that. So we'll touch on how they can monetize also through affiliate marketing, which is what we'll be talking about here.
Very good. Very good. That's sounds good. And we, of course, we talk about passive income, and passive income is essentially revenue that you get paid ongoing for one-time work. So that's a real hot button of mine. That's something I've had the good fortune of being able to do for many, many, many years now.
So James, why don't you explain to the audience what is an affiliate program? What is affiliate marketing? Actually, just an overview if you could.
Sure. And so affiliate marketing and affiliate programs, as we call them, is really quite simple. It's basically a relationship between two business owners or two webmasters, one who has a product for sale and the other one who has an audience that's interested in that product. And when, in our example here, a webmaster or a podcaster refers a listener to a merchant who has that product for sale, that is tracked through what we call an affiliate link. And that transaction is tracked so that when the purchase is made, the referring party, the podcaster in this example, gets a little alert in their email that says, hey, you just referred a paying customer to us. You just earned $25 or whatever the dollar amount is. So really all it is a business relationship between two parties who agree to accept referrals and agree to send referrals in return for a trackable commission.
Beauty. Sounds easy enough, especially if you have an audience and you know your products really well. So that's a good way for people to get into earning some money for sure. What has your experience been specifically with affiliate marketing in your life?
This is actually where I started online. Maybe that's not true so much, but when I really got serious about the internet, it was because of affiliate programs. And essentially it was back in 1999. That a good friend of mine wandered into my home office and showed me a little website that he'd created, and he was referring customers to another company who were paying him a commission for every successful transaction. And it was to the amount of $4.35 per referral, which, you know, that sounded interesting enough, and that was great enough, until he told me how much he was earning, and it was into the tens of thousands of dollars per month, because he was literally referring a ton of people to them. Then he had my attention, and his name was Sean, and I said, Sean, would you mind teaching me how to do this? And he said, sure, I'll teach you how to do this. And for the next 6 months, I got busy, and anytime I got stuck or had a question, I would give Sean a call, and he would help me work it through. And before long, I was starting to earn some very nice checks from referring customers to other webmasters or other merchants who had products for sale. And then from that point, we really never looked back. We've had a pretty interesting career with it. I wrote the Affiliate Marketer's Handbook back in 2002, which went on to become a very top seller. Back in its day, it was one of the very first ebooks. We, of course, founded the Affiliate Buzz podcast because of that book, which is my current podcast and my always podcast. I've had it for just about 12 years now. And affiliate marketing is an industry that I've spoken in, worked in, lived and breathed the affiliate programs for probably well over 14, 15 years now.
That's a long history for sure. You're around from the beginnings of affiliate marketing, it sounds like.
So, yeah, since the beginning of dirt, as we say it.
Yeah. So why do you love affiliate marketing other than, of course, obviously you can make a lot of money doing it and you've seen so much success, but what really grabs you about it? What do you gravitate towards? What makes you really passionate about it?
Well, so much of what we do online is in the hope of developing a recurring revenue stream and a lifestyle so that we can get freedom. And unfortunately, with most traditional businesses, they're so heavy to take care of, where you've got customers and clients and leases and employees and mountains of bookkeeping and marketing and sales. I mean, you could just go on and on and on. And I've had businesses like that, and I've done well at them. But when I saw affiliate marketing, where you had a relationship with the merchant who did the heavy lifting, they're the one that are collecting the check, they're the one that has to inventory everything, they are the one that has to handle refunds and deal with the clients, and they're the ones with the employees and all of the brick and mortar type business stuff that's needed to run a successful business. Whereas the affiliate, we don't have any of that. All we do is build up our online presence, build up our audiences, and get ourselves into a position of authority so that we can refer customers to reputable companies in return for a commission. So it's very light business. There's no employees, there's no inventory to support. We don't need a building or a lease. We don't need any of the stuff that the traditional businesses have. And I'm a big fan of the lifestyle, not having to go to work. And I mentioned it, I haven't gone to a job for, I don't even know how long, definitely for 15 plus years since we found affiliate marketing. And affiliate marketing was the first really light business that we got involved with, where we had the freedom, where my wife, she also works at home, as you know, Arlene, where she has managed to be able to go to all of the teacher-parent interviews and special field trips and just all the stuff that you want to do but you can't do because you're working. She's had the ability to do so many of those things just because she's got the freedom of time, number one, and the money, number two, just to be able to stay home. Now, we still work hard. We still work at home, but it gives the freedom, and I think that's why I like affiliate marketing the most.
Yeah, I think it sounds like a lifestyle type business, right? You get out of it what you put into it, for one, and then also the ability to make money around the clock. That's the one thing that got me when you first introduced me to affiliate marketing. It's like, well, you're earning money when you're sleeping, even. Like,
that's
you put
true.
In the work, and then, you know, the internet doesn't sleep. Your online stores are open 24/7. People are online around the clock, right? So it doesn't matter what you're doing. Your business, your affiliate marketing business, can still be earning money, which I really love. Like, never close the doors, right?
Absolutely.
So, yeah, a lifestyle business, no cap on your income. And, yeah, I think it's a limitless business anyway.
It is.
We are up against a break right now, so we're going to take off for a couple seconds here, and we will return and talk about how to make money with affiliate programs, specifically in podcasting. So don't go away. We'll be right back.
More Podcasting Mastery with James and Kimberly from the Secret Beach Hut Studio after this.
Is your podcast getting bogged down because of time or technical issues? Would you prefer to let someone else handle all of the production and technical details? Our virtual producer works remotely from a studio to provide you with production, technical, and creative assistance. Our virtual producer will call you and your guest by phone or Skype, and then record, produce, and upload each episode with SEO-friendly show notes to your website for automated distribution to social media and the major podcast directories. Sound intriguing? Visit podcastingmastery.com/virtualproducer to learn more. That's www.podcastingmastery.com/virtualproducer. Is your website out of date? Is it mobile friendly? Why not let us design your website and we'll make sure it looks the way it should on all platforms and devices, including iPhones, iPads, and other smartphones and tablets. We'll even optimize your site for search engines and make it easy for you to share your content and products on social sites such as Facebook and Twitter with built-in sharing features. For more information and to schedule your no-obligation free consultation, go to podcastingmastery.com/website. Once again, that's www.podcastingmastery.com/website.
When James Martell launched his affiliate Buzz podcast in the spring of 2003, he never dreamed he'd be sitting here all these years later with over 3 million downloads and 400 plus episodes. He gets thousands of listeners tuning in each week, but it wasn't always like that. In the beginning, he had to figure things out on his own. There were no books or guides available, so there was a lot of trial and error. And while there are many pieces to the puzzle for constructing a successful podcast, James Martell has boiled it down to the 12 core elements of the No Fail Podcast in his most recent free report. Available for a limited time at podcastingmastery.com/no-fail.
Now back to Podcasting Mastery from the Secret Beach Hut Studio.
And we are back. Hi, James. You still around?
I am still around.
I saw you sneak out for a minute there, so... All right, so we are talking about podcasting and affiliate marketing and how podcasters can make money with affiliate programs. So basically create a passive income stream through their podcast.
It's a great topic, and it's two of my favorite topics, affiliate marketing and podcasting. It doesn't really get much better than that for me. And it really stemmed out of the book way back in 2002, The Affiliate Marketer's Handbook, which spawned... I guess for lack of a better word, the Affiliate Buzz, which was, of course, one of the very first podcasts as well. And we launched that in 2003 to much fanfare, I will say. And back then, a podcast making money with affiliate programs was something that just wasn't even thought of. And even today, I look at a lot of podcasts that I know are doing okay, but they could do so much better if they would just learn how to monetize them a little bit better. And affiliate programs really make it quite easy to do that. And you shared a podcast in the last episode, and maybe you could just touch on that a little bit, because they were a travel company, Indie Travel Podcast, and they were a couple that are traveling the world. And they're writing little guidebooks, little travel books in the areas that they're staying. But they also monetize their podcast. Explain that, if you would.
Yeah, so they're monetizing their podcast through affiliate marketing programs. So if they find a service that's useful, for example, they have an insurance company that they go through. It's called World Nomad. So they sell travel insurance online. And this is something that they use often, and they're advocates of it. They talk about it in their podcast, how good it is, and naturally it makes sense for them to tell their audience, hey, you should use this too. So they go out and sign up for their affiliate program, and then they have a search function on their website with the World Nomads. So their visitors can go right in there, pop in all their information, get a quote, there you go. So they're using products every day in their travels that are beneficial to their audience. And they're recommending them because they love them, and they're earning commissions off of it. So anything from, you know, travel gear, backpacks, insurance, flights, cheap flights, things like that, hostel booking sites. So it's really good. They just do little plugins. They let their audience know, you know, we use these services and we love them, and yes, we make money from them, and that helps us continue on this lifestyle. It helps us explore the world so that we can tell you about it and, like, give you advice, right? So they're doing it a couple different ways. Their main source, it's looking like affiliate programs. They also do create their own guidebooks, like you mentioned. So they've got some e-commerce going on, and they sell their own products. They look like digital products from what I've seen so far. So.
And that's true. That's very well said, and that is a great little synopsis of how anybody can make money with affiliate programs using a podcast. And in our particular case, we do earn money as well through our podcast, through the affiliate, through Podcasting Mastery here. And it could be something as simple as if I was to recommend the headset that I'm actually wearing right now that I use all the time, and I would say to check it out, go to podcastingmastery.com/headset. What that will do is it will forward you directly to a page on Amazon.com where you can buy that and learn about that headset. And that if you like the way this headset sounds as a podcast and you like the way it looks on Amazon.com and you purchase it, because you went through my link, we get paid a commission for that.
So help us out and go there if you need a headset.
But that's the way it works, and that's how we do it. So anytime that we have a product or service on the show that we think is helpful or would be helpful to you, we will recommend it. We'll always say that, you know, we will get a paid commission for that. We're not shy about sharing. That's one of the reasons we do it. And probably the same reason you're going to have, if you don't already have a podcast, that probably the same, one of the ways that you'll monetize it. We've talked about probably half a dozen ways already through these first 8 or 9 episodes, and we'll continue to talk about ways we earn money with podcasting. We're not shy to mention that we make money that way, and you don't have to be either. Maybe talk to that a little bit, Kimberly. And that travel podcast is a great example of that. And because you've done so much traveling yourself, and you have your own website, TikiKiki.com, where you do the same as far as recommending products and services, in your case, in Southeast Asia.
Yeah.
Talk about, do you ever receive any pushback from people say, hey, I don't want you making any money from recommending this stuff?
When I first got into affiliate marketing, about, when was that, like 2008, 2009, I did see a little bit. Sometimes when I was even posting on other people's sites and things like that, I would see comments from people say, oh, well, this page is just about an affiliate link. They're just making money from this. You know, there was a lot of hostility. Not a lot, but I mean, I'd come across it, and I don't anymore, because that's just how people, you're offering them free information. You're doing all of the work. And you're producing this content, right? And you're doing it because you enjoy it. And you're doing it because it's free. Nobody's paying you to go out there and write all this content and create a website and have graphics created and everything, right? Like, a lot of the time, affiliate marketers start out with hobby sites. And then they monetize after with affiliate marketing, because they're doing this as a passion, as a hobby, right? And then once they can monetize, then... Right, like, that's great. You know, obviously, it's good to turn your hobby into a business, but I don't see it as much anymore. Definitely, I think people, if you disclose it, if you let them know, hey, this is, yeah, I do earn a commission, but it's because, hey, I'm reviewing this trip that I actually went on. I use this service. I'm letting you know how it is. You know, you're providing a lot of value to that person before they even get to the purchasing process. So, I think it's good. I don't think there's much pushback at all. I think people like helping you out, especially if they're a follower and they're a fan, and yeah, they want to help you out because they want to help see more content. They want what you got.
Absolutely.
Including from your programs, right?
You bet.
Yeah, and I think another thing I want to touch on is a lot of podcasters out there talk about monetizing podcasts, and every single time we hear about sponsorship, you guys, sponsors for your podcast. That's not the only way to monetize a podcast, and that's what people seem to think. So I think talking about affiliate marketing with this is really important, because there are so many ways, and there are companies like Indie Travel Podcast who are doing exactly that. So no, you don't need sponsors for every show. You can monetize through affiliate marketing. It's a lot of fun. It's really great. You're helping people out.
And you can monetize it, as you said, a number of other ways as well. And actually, of all of the ways to monetize a podcast, and I've monetized the Affiliate Buzz for some, I guess, 15 years now. No, 12 years now. I don't have sponsors. Not interested. Thank you very much. There's much more profitable ways in my particular show to monetize the show than, and I'm speaking about the Affiliate Buzz podcast in this context, than actually going out and seeking sponsors. And same with for Podcasting Mastery. Podcasting Mastery, there's so many ways that we can earn revenue from our podcast, just as anybody can, with a little bit of thought and figuring out, you know, how to find a podcast, for example. It's just a matter of really digging in and just doing a Google search. Whatever your topic is that you're looking for, an affiliate program, just type the topic name and then the word affiliate program and watch them come up in the Google search, and then just look through them. And the whole key to this is marrying up the products and services, preferably that you're using yourself, not always, but hopefully most of the time, so you can talk about those products from real experience and share real stories and real benefits as to why you like them and why you're recommending them. And if you can do that and marry it up to your audience who needs those products and services, then you've got a much more likely, higher likelihood of being successful with it.
Mm-hmm. So that actually touches on the question that I was about to ask you, which was, how does a podcaster find an affiliate program? So it's just as simple as having your topic and talking about your topic or your particular product or a service, and then just going out and doing a Google search and seeing if they have one, and then going through the sign-up process, which is step-by-step, so very, very simple, right?
Absolutely, and on that note, if I may, it's free to join affiliate programs. It never costs you any money to join, so there's no risk there. The only thing you want to make sure as a podcaster that you will do is when you fill in the application to join that merchant's affiliate program, take the time to actually fill out the entire application, because they do reject. They don't know who you are or how you're going to be marketing their products and recommending their products. You'll find that you probably would get rejected. Whereas if you take the time to fill out the application properly, and when they ask you who are you and how do you plan on marketing our products, tell them you're a podcaster. This is the name of your show. You're listed on iTunes, Spreaker, Stitcher, Webmaster Radio, wherever your podcast is hosted, plus on your website. You also share it in social media. You share it with your newsletter subscribers. All the different ways that people find out about your podcast, just let them know that, and then there's a really high likelihood that you'll be approved for that affiliate program.
Okay, that's great info. So I want to talk actually about something really cool about affiliate programs, because a lot of the times when you join the program, it'll give you a breakdown of the commission structure and everything. So it'll tell you, if you sell one a day, this is your monthly income. If you sell five a day, this is going to be your monthly income. But there's actually programs out there that offer recurring revenues. So I would like you to talk a little bit about the recurring revenue.
Absolutely. This is another great benefit of affiliate marketing. And these are hard to find. I'll preface this with that. Some affiliate programs that actually pay recurring revenue are not plentiful, unfortunate, but when you can find them, they're awesome. And a recurring revenue program, affiliate program, will pay you for the lifetime of the customer. And I'll give you some examples. There's one company called GetResponse, which is an email marketing company, and they pay a 33% recurring commission. So if you refer a customer over to GetResponse, let's say you have an audience that's interested in online marketing, internet marketing, growing their business online, business podcasts of some sort, and you refer a listener of yours over to GetResponse, they're going to pay you anywhere between $4.95 to $148.50, depending on the size of the package the client purchases from them, per month. So this was recurring, ongoing, for the lifetime of the customer.
That's a lot easier.
It is easier, absolutely. Yeah. One-time effort, get paid ongoing. Another great one is one called Scribe Content. And this is a $97 a month product, very popular in the SEO world. It's a tool set for webmasters, any business owner really, who's looking to manage and build up their search engine traffic, will need a tool like Scribe Content. And it's a $97 product, $97 per month, and they will pay you a 33% recurring commission on that referral. So that's $32.01 per month. If I've got my math right, doesn't sound right, but it's right around the $32-$33 per referral per month. So you imagine if you refer them 100 people, you're earning $3,300 a month.
That's pretty good.
And that's ongoing for the lifetime of the customer. So These are what we call recurring revenue affiliate programs.
And you've actually put something together for our audience so that they don't have to go out and seek these recurring revenue programs, right?
Yeah. Well, this is a good start for that, and it took a about 3 hours to find these. Actually, I didn't actually look for these myself, although I know many of the companies and I actually refer a few of them myself. Arlene, my wife, actually hunted them down for me, and they did take some digging, I'll tell you. And they pay anywhere from 25% to 15%, 40% to 10%, 5%. 25%, 20%. So they're high-end products, and they pay ongoing recurring income. And so you can find this report at podcastingmastery.com/recurring.
Excellent. So let's shift gears here. I know we're coming up against the clock pretty quick. So how about you go over the podcast of the week for this week?
Yeah, this is a good one because this will tie into what we're talking about today, interestingly enough, about making money with a podcast. And this podcast is called the Strength Coach Podcast, and I know there's a lot of coaches out there that could benefit massively from their own podcast who don't already have a podcast. And the gentleman who owns this podcast, his name is Michael Boyle, and he's a strength and conditioning coach, and that's what he talks about. His episodes are about 80 minutes long. So about an hour and 20 minutes, and he interviews a ton of guests. Now, the way he monetizes his show is through the sale of sponsorships. So as soon as you hear the intro, part of the intro is brought to you by Perform Better. He talks about a merchant there. He also has a number of his own products, including training courses. He's got one called Michael Boyle's Strength and Conditioning System. It's a 6-DVD set plus a training manual. And basically what he's done here is he's recorded what he called the closed-door seminar that was 8 hours in length. And then he also developed a training manual around that, and now he sells it for $199. So he sells one of his products, his own products, on his own show. He also has, it's called strengthcoach.com. It's a membership site where his listeners can subscribe to his membership site to get in behind the scenes and to work with Michael and get access to other products and services, hang out with other members. And he charges $129 a year for access to that, or $14.95 a month. Plus, he promotes his clinics, his workout clinics, and his seminars. And also, he promotes affiliate programs. And one of them I noticed is Audible.com, which was purchased recently by Amazon. And anybody he sends over to Audible who takes advantage of their free trial, he earns $5 to send people over to take the free trial. So here's a great little podcast that monetizes it through 1, sponsorships, 2, his own product, 3, his membership site, 4, his clinics, and 5 would be affiliate programs.
Yeah, so really, there's many, many ways that you can monetize your site. So
absolutely, there's no end to it. There's
start
no end to
one.
It. And I think clearly, there's multiple ways you can monetize a single podcast or a single episode as well. So why don't you do this as we wrap up here? I know you have a podcast tool of the day. Take us through that.
Alrighty, it is blogtalkradio.com, which if you are familiar with podcasting already, you might have heard about it. It's getting pretty big. It's a podcasting platform that allows you to record right in their system, edit the audio, and have callers onto your show, which is a pretty cool feature. So they give you a little phone number where you can tell your listeners, hey, call in to the show, here's the number, and it'll patch them right in. So that's a pretty awesome feature. Very cool. It's also got a really, really nice analytics dashboard. It's super user-friendly, really easy to use. I mean, if you've never used any platforms like this before, you can get right in there and know what you're doing. So yeah. Saves you a lot of time, really great platform. You can check that out on podcastingmastery.com/blogtalkradio.
And I've actually had a chance. Blog Talk Radio would be really kind of a competitor to Spreaker, where they both give you your own interface. They both allow you to record directly into their system. They both have a lot of great features. You'd mentioned a few. In addition, Blog Talk Radio allows you, as does Spreaker, the ability, once you hit the publish button on your latest episode, it can update the podcasting directories, including iTunes. It can update your social media accounts in some cases as well. So lots of great little tools and functionality built right into the system. Of course, these are paid services. They do have free versions of them, but very quickly you want to get into the paid versions of them because you want access to some of the features that you don't get when you are using the free tools.
All right. I think it's about time to wrap up here. If you guys have your own podcast or a podcasting tool that you'd like us to feature on the show, simply email us all the details at featureme@podcastingmastery.com, and we may just do exactly that.
Keep in mind that if there's anything that we mentioned here that you missed, we do keep all the notes for you, and you'll find the notes for this episode at podcastingmastery.com/009. So, Kimberly, thank you so much. And to all our listeners and podcasting friends, we'll catch you in the next episode of Podcasting Mastery from the Secret Beachhead Studio.
Thanks for joining us in the Secret Beach Hut Studio. If you are ready to start your podcasting adventure and to learn the secrets of creating a profitable podcast, James Martell has boiled it down for you to the 12 core elements of the No Fail Podcast in his most recent free report, available for a limited time at podcastingmastery.com/nofail. But don't wait, this report won't be free for long. So be sure to grab your free copy today to learn the secrets of podcasting your way to a stress-free lifestyle at podcastingmastery.com/nofail.